Hey y'all, it's the Scentsy Lady of East Texas. Sometimes you can feel like you may be in a rut in your business, but the thing is, we go through hills and valleys in so many aspects of our lives. We can get bored at our jobs. We can get overwhelmed in our marriages. We can have friendships that flop. It's just a fact of life, really. I mean, honestly, but at the end of the day, it's how we handle it that matters. And in 10 years of being a Scentsy consultant, I can't tell you the number of times that I've been ready to just throw in the towel. I get discouraged when a party that I've worked so hard for flops. It literally closes with like $40. And it's like, really? Like, did I fail as a consultant? Or when a consultant or a friend or contact talks to you about joining and then either doesn't join or, better yet, joins under somebody else. That hurts, right? It's disappointing. It's discouraging. We can burn ourselves out if we are constantly doing the same old, honestly, and we don't give ourselves time to just step away and fill our banks, really. If you don't have an accountability partner that is pouring into you, it's hard to lead when you're empty. You can't pour from an empty cup, right? So it's super important for you to dig in and figure out, A, why you're in the rut that you're in, what caused it, how bad do you want to get out of it, and then what steps are you gonna take to get out of it, really? So just a little bit of transparency backstory. So I've been in for 10 years. I just celebrated my 10th anniversary. And I would say maybe two summers ago, I was ready to quit. I was burnt out. I had given all that I had to my business. I had a job outside the home and it was 45 minutes away. So I was driving 45 minutes working for 8 hours for somebody else. It was out in the sticks, so I didn't have good cell phone reception. I couldn't obviously make deliveries during my lunch hour, and then I would drive 45 minutes home. So at the end of the day, I'm giving roughly, like I'm working for 8 hours, an hour there, an hour home, and an hour for lunch. I'm giving roughly 11 to 12 hours of my day to somebody else, right? I am pouring into her business. I am stuck once I'm there, can't have a lunch break, can't work my business during my lunch, I don't have good cell phone reception, so I can't even do my follow-ups, right? Y'all, I worked there for 3 years, and it sucked the absolute life out of me. I can't even tell you how sad I was. I felt like I had poured so much time, energy, and effort into my Scentsy business, all for it to just be on hold. I literally felt like I was in a holding pattern during those 3 years, and it made me sad. It made me resentful. I resented my husband, and I know that during that time, I was not a pleasant wife. I was not a good friend. I would come home and I would dive into my business for a couple of hours every night because, hello, I had a team. I mean, there were over 200 of us at that moment. And it was hard. It was very hard. And I went through questioning, you know, why me? Why am I here? But you know what? In December of last year, or actually November, I was laid off. On November 11th, my boss called me into the office and said that she was eliminating my position and that December 12th would be my last day. Y'all, I was stunned. I was literally stunned. I had no idea what I had done. I didn't deserve, you know, to be let go. How was this business going to go on without me? I had poured my heart and soul into this business, right? Wrong. They were going to go on without me. She needed to get rid, like hindsight's 2020, she needed to get rid of one of the top paying employees. So yeah, here I am being resentful that I've put my business on hold for 3 years for this woman, for this company, only to be told your position's being eliminated and in 1 month you're going to be unemployed. Y'all, like, that was a slap in the face to me. It was like it was a hard hit of reality, honestly. Because whatever I'm involved in, I give it 112%, period. I'm a perfectionist, and at the end of the day, I treat anything like it is mine. I treated her business, her company, like it was mine. I was the receptionist, front office person, and so I was the front line. I was the face of her business. And let me tell you the pride that I put into that. Yes, I was resentful about being there, but at the end of the day, that was still my job and that's still what was required of me. And I had built relationships with those customers and they expected me to give them 110%, right? So I was laid off in December. And let me tell you, I came home and I cried and I cried and I cried. And I just told my husband, like, I can't believe how much I've given this company only to be released without thought. Like, on my last day, not one person said, bye, we're gonna miss you, nothing. It was like I had been shunned and I was heartbroken. Like, I was so sad. And I stayed in that depressed state for about a week, honestly. I was lonely. I felt like a failure. Here I am, 40 and unemployed, and I've been like, my position's been eliminated, and I have this business that's kind of stalled out. Like, I don't know, I'm gonna have to build back, you know, from having put my business on hold basically for 3 years to work for somebody else. It was hard. It was a hard mental place to be. And then one day I woke up and I realized, Autumn, like, this is an opportunity that you can't pass up. This is an opportunity for you to balls to the wall, work with your team, give your customers all that you've got, because you now have your 11 hours of your day back and you can devote whatever you want during those 11 hours. You can do this. And I also told myself, my husband deserves more than this. My husband's gotten my leftovers at the end of the day for 3 years. I gave that company all that I had, and then I would come home pissed off and resentful towards him for even having that job that I didn't really want, but yet I had been let go and then acted like the world stopped turning. Like, y'all, it was so messed up. It was such a messed up place to be. But there I was, right? So what am I going to do with that? Well, in January, it was like, because like I said, I got laid off December 12th. Well, by then, you're so close to Christmas, the shipping cut off, blah, blah, blah. So January 1, I'm like, okay, it's a clean slate. It's a new year. It's a new me. I'm going to give this all I've got. And y'all, I can't even tell you. It's like I'm a brand new consultant again. I've got this party station that I've set up where I'm rocking these 30-minute parties. I'm able to meet with my customers at any point during the day when I didn't have that availability during that 3-year stint. So y'all, it is a blessing. Like, the biggest blessing in my life was honestly to have been let go from that position, because I was in the mindset of, they need me. I can't leave. I'm unhappy, but I can't leave. But yet they did away with my position. They were willing to work without me. So I needed to shift my mindset and realize that I was going to be okay without them too. And that my husband and our household deserved more than me just being all up in my feelings, right? So a little bit of a squirrel chasing session there, but I just want to let you know, in 10 years, I've experienced plenty of my highs and lows, plenty, but that was definitely the lowest of the low And then boom, it shifted. And now it's the highest of the high. I am excited to work my business. I'm excited to reach out to my customers. I'm excited when I get to make deliveries. I'm excited when I get to party online with people. Even though we're in the midst of a global pandemic, I am still so thankful because for 3 years, I felt like my business was on a complete stall, really. It had just stalled out and I was stuck. I was very, very stuck. And so if you have been kind of in a rut with your business, I challenge you to find something about your business that brings you joy. Because for me, it was the availability. It was knowing that I was going to be available for my team. I was going to be available for my customers. I had 24 hours in my day, and 11 of those hours were not devoted to somebody else. They were mine. And so I took back control of my time and my schedule. And that got me excited again. And if you do work a job outside the home and you're feeling totally spread thin, because I think at the end of the day, that was my resentment. It was like, I get home at 6 o'clock, by the time I eat dinner, say hi to my husband, try to do a party, try to make a couple of deliveries, it's time for me to go to bed because I've got to do it all over again. Like, I felt so spread thin and pulled in so many different directions. And it wasn't fair to me, but then I know at the end of the day, it wasn't fair to my customers or to my husband. And so it was a very, very hard place to be. But I am so happy now I get to work my business on my terms. And so if you have been in a rut, I challenge you to go back to what started it all for you, what brings you joy in this business, and focus on that. And then the rest will fall into place. If you need a mentor, if you need a guide, somebody to talk to, somebody to drag you out of that rut, reach out to me. I will be your accountability partner all day long, and I will enjoy every moment of that opportunity. Because y'all, I've been there. 2 years ago, I was literally ready to give my downline to my frontline director. I was like, I'm done. I can't do this anymore. It's too hard. And I'm so thankful that I pushed through. I'm so thankful because here I am on the other side and I've gotten rid of that job that was sucking the life out of me. And I am giving my Scentsy business 110%. And that's what it deserves, honestly. So if you've been in a rut, I challenge you, dig your way out because your business deserves it and your team deserves it. Y'all have a great day and I will talk to y'all soon. And if, like I said, if you really need an accountability partner, reach out to me because I promise there is so much more to life than a job that can suck the joy out of every part of your day. And you are so much better than that. Y'all have a good one.